Hey, so about a month ago, I was playing around with my field battery. I heard a loud pop from the converter and a loud pop from this. My 2 amp hour battery is effectively dead. I can't charge it. It will not discharge. So I'm left with a little bit of a conundrum. Do I send it off for warranty repair and run the risk of Ego, the company that makes it, saying, hey, you violated your warranty because you were using it in such a way that it drew too much current and it blew the battery. We're not going to cover it. By the way, we'll go ahead and dispose of it for you. Or I can take it apart and I can learn something from it. So why let them have all the fun? We're going to take this son of a bitch apart and find out what makes it tick. Okay, so to take this battery apart, which I've done before, there's a couple of star screws that are in here, and I don't know how well those are going to show up, but there's a bunch of these little star screws that I need to remove, and this is the bit that I use. And inside here, let's see if I can turn that around in such a way that it'll show. This is that epoxy resin. Something inside of here, I think, is what popped, and I can't get to it. I don't know if I blew a capacitor or blew a transformer or something else. So now we just gotta take out these screws here to remove this piece. So, removing these 4 screws here. Okay, so the inside here, we have the individual cells for the battery. Yep, they just lift right out. And I can get rid of that shell. Looks like I'm married to these two for the time being. Have got a whole bunch of batteries on the back here. So I have 2 modules of 7 batteries each. We have these cables that come out of this epoxy area and run along the length of here. And then you can see that I have got 1 cable that goes to each battery. So each one of these, I keep calling them batteries, they're actually cells. Each one of these cells has its own wire. So what we need to do now is get all of this stuff completely torn apart. If getting to this point of disassembly means my warranty is still intact for some reason, this is gonna void it for sure. It's more than capable of delivering an instant discharge of 2 amps, and it takes less than 1 amp to stop the human heart. If I die, honey, I love you. Alright, I got a tiny shock from that one. Just try to remember not to do anything that stupid again. Cutting all of them at once, they probably were bridged by the blade here. So there's one module. 3.6 volts. That's 3.68 volts. 3.69. 3.68. 3.68, 3.67. So, as we can see, that there's a tiny variance, about 0.02 of a volt. Next step, I guess, is to remove the cells from this pack. My goal is to take these and turn it into... So this was 56 volts at 2 amp hours. I think what I want to try and do is get this down to like 24 volts at 4 amp hours.
My telescope mount, the paramount, runs at 48 volts. So I can buy a 24 volt to 48 volt step up converter. So this would be like Frankenstein Jr. And that would give me, if I had a total of 4 amp hours at 24 volts, by doubling the voltage, in a perfect world, I have my amp hours. So I would only get 2 amp hours at 48 volts. And that would get me a whole night. And I would do a large pointing run and hit several different targets. If I were to step that down for, by using a 24 volt to 12 volt buck converter like I'm doing currently, in a perfect world, that would give me 8 amp hours. I currently take 15 amp hours at 56 volts, and when I step that down to 12 volts, Frankenstein tells me that I've got almost a kilowatt hour of power in those batteries. And that little Intel compute stick at 5 volts, probably running maybe 500 milliamp hours at idle, it's never going to drain through almost a whole kilowatt hour of power. I think that Frankenstein is overkill for going to a grade school and doing 2 hours with some kids. We're going to see what I can do with this and see if I can't make a small little power pack. That's the direction I think I'm going to head in, and I think that this is going to be a fun little learning experience for me. So thanks for watching. Subscribe if you haven't. I don't post very often, but when I do, I try to make it as useful as possible and try to cram as much cool shit into a single video as I can. So if you like this video or any of my other videos, be sure to subscribe, because once you do, you'll know when I post my next video. Thanks for watching. Hope you all have some clear skies and keep looking up.